The recording has started. Please observe this very carefully. It is very easy. There is nothing, you don't have to draw XY line at all for isometric chapter. There is nothing called XY line. There is no VPHP, no beta angle, no Pearson, and nothing. It is simple, very, very simple. Just observe this carefully. First, I will tell you, I will teach you how to draw square prism. Okay? It's only just observe. I'll show you how to draw square prism. So this is a square and this is a prism, right? There's nothing called edge condition, corner condition. Not even edge condition, corner condition. It is just simple draw square prism. Okay. So now here no namings. I'm going to, instead of namings, I'm going to give some numbers. Initially you follow this method. Once you get used to it, once you are clear with the concept, then directly, no naming, nothing, directly you can do it. Okay, just observe, this bottom left corner, I am going to name this as corner 1, this as 2, this as 3, and this as 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Are these lines perpendicular to each other? 1, 2, 2, 3, it is perpendicular to each other. Now, if you open your sketchbook, okay, go to the last isometric sheet. I'll write in the bottom one here like this. If you go to last isometric sheet, over there, your regular sheets were exactly like this. Graph sheet was like this. Whereas in isometric sheets, lines are not straight, it is inclined to some angle. The angle inclination is 30. Your sheets are inclined, your lines are inclined like this. Okay? These angles are 30° to the baseline. If you draw one line, it is 30, it makes 30° to the horizontal. Okay. So for example, if your lines are like this, I'll show you. Your lines are like this. Pick up one corner, and next corner. So this you just draw a horizontal line. If you draw a horizontal line, this line and this line, it is making 30°. It is making 30° each. Okay. And like this, if you draw at the bottom, you have to, this is corner number 1. This corner number 1, what I am talking, here you have to name this corner number, that is corner number 1. Now let us see that the square prism, you have drawn 40mm size. You need to say from 1 to 2, it is 40, 2 to 3, it is 40, 4 also is 40, 4 to 1 also it is 40. In regular sheets, if it is 40mm size, how many boxes you are going to leave it? So from 1 to 2, if it is 40, you will leave 4 boxes and you will draw line. From here, 4 box gap, 1 line. From here, 4 box gap, 1 line. From 4 box gap, 4, you will close it back. Correct? In isometric also, you have to do in the same manner. You should not take your scale for the measurement. You should use your scale to draw a line. You have to just count the number of boxes. Okay? I will tell you how to do it. For example, 1 to 2, if it is 40, means 4 boxes. Here also, I will explain this line further, a little bit for your understanding. Okay, so this is point number 1. From here, there is a line, right? Along this line, you have to count how many boxes? 4 boxes. From here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Stop. This is corner number 2. Right? Now, 2 to 3. This has become perpendicular. So here, at this point 2, I have 2 options. One, I can move it further. Second option is going perpendicular. So here, from 2, is it continued or is it moving perpendicular? It is moving perpendicular. So here, I have to move it in this direction. On 2 to 3 line, how many box gap? 4 box gap. So here also, on the line 2 to 3, you have to leave 4 more boxes and you have to do it. From here, 1, 2, 3. Let us assume there is one more box. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is corner number 3.
Okay.
Then again, from 3, 4, it is 40. 3 to 4, again 4 boxes. 1, 4, corner number 4. And 4 to 1, again it is 40. 4 to 1, 1, 2, like this. You have to name the box.
Okay?
I will make it more clear. I will erase this. I hope how to take, how to count the number of boxes. I think you are clear. That part, we will draw it bigger man. So, what did I do? I've drawn a line, I've taken one point, this is column 1, 2, like this. I have two lines, each incline at an angle 30 degrees. 1, 2, it is 40 mm, so it means 4 boxes. If it is 50 mm, 5 boxes, 60 mm, 6 boxes, like that. So from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, this column number 2, at this point I have one line like this. In this direction, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is column number 3. Over here, again, I have one line like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, this is column number 4, and from here, 1, 2, 3, column number 1. So I've got the base profile, square prism, square bottom one square, top one square, it's a prism, so bottom square, I've got it. I have to get the top square. What is the axis length? The question is square prism of 40 mm side, 60 mm axis length. So 60 mm axis length means height of the prism is 60. So from each and every corner, draw a vertical line. Okay, 60 is the axis length means number of box leaving is 6 boxes. Okay, as I said, 40 mm is 4 boxes, 60 mm is 6 boxes. So from each and every corner, you count 6 boxes and mark the top corner. From here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Corner number 1 in the top, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Corner number 2 in the top, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Corner number 3 in the top, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Corner number 4 in the top. If I connect this, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1. Okay, so this is the way of constructing square prism. Now in this, can you tell me which face you are able to see and which face you are not able to see? Is this top face is very clear? I mean to say, are you not, people not feeling like you are seeing the square prism from top at some angle? Yeah, so when you are seeing the square prism at, from top at some angle, mean to say you are able to see the top face. How about bottom square face? Mean to say, how about corner number 3? Physically it is present, but practically it cannot be seen. Okay, so in that case, here no need to draw dotted line also. You can just erase that line. So this is your isometric chapter. To do this much, this carries 20 marks. This is how you are supposed to construct. Okay, you don't have to draw any dotted line, you don't have to draw any axis line, no naming, no numbering, nothing. Square prism of 40 mm side, 60 mm axis length means, square prism of 40 mm side, 60 mm axis length means, draw a line, two lines, 40 mm sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, one marking, 1, 2, 3, 4, second marking, 1, 2, 3, 4, third marking, 1, 2, fourth mark. Axis length 60. So from each and every corner, draw vertical line. Axis length 60 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Top face. That's all. In the line which is inside the solid, that you can erase it. Line which is inside the solid, that you have to erase it. So if you do like this, this is how you do isometric problems on the sheet. Okay, this carries 20 marks cross problem. Square pyramid of 40 mm sides. Square pyramid of 40 mm sides, 60 mm axis length. Square pyramid. Okay, so pyramid sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so once it is a pyramid, pyramid axis length starts from the center of the face, correct? For which you have to get the midpoint of the face. So, midpoint, don't draw diagonal lines. Instead of drawing diagonal lines, divide the profile into two equal halves. Like how? Midpoint of this line, opposite midpoint, midpoint of this line, opposite midpoint. So this is the midpoint of your plane. Axis length 60 means from here, 6 boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the axis length, to draw a dark line, the outermost points. This is your square pyramid. Inner line which goes inside the solid, bottom face, innermost line, this is it. So this is how you construct square pyramid of 40 mm sides, 60 mm axis length. Okay? So let us check.
check out how this is. Guys, are you, did you understand what I said now?